Hi and welcome to Emville. Today we're going to teach you how to make healthy holiday recipes, and we're making a gingerbread cake. It's much easier to make, and it takes a few simple ingredients, which are 2 cups of whole wheat flour, we've got some ginger powder, 1 teaspoon of ginger powder, as well as 1/2 teaspoon of fresh ginger. That adds a nice little kick. And we've got a pinch of ground cloves, along with a pinch of salt and 1 teaspoon of baking soda. We have 1/2 cup of butter, which is brought to room temperature, so it's easier to beat. We've got 1/2 cup of light brown sugar and 1/2 cup of sugar, along with the rind of 1 lemon, 2 eggs, and 1 cup of milk. So the first thing we want to do is preheat the oven to 325. Next up, we're going to mix the dry ingredients together, which are the 2 cups of flour, along with the salt, and the baking soda. Next, we add the ginger powder, the fresh ginger, and the cloves. And we're just gonna whisk that together and keep it to the side. In another bowl, we wanna take the 1/2 cup of butter, light brown sugar, whisk that either with an electric mixer or with a hand whisk. Occasionally, you might want to scrape down the bowl so that you make sure everything gets really blended. So that's been about 2 minutes, and you can see how it's a bit lighter in color. Next, we want to add the eggs. Then we want to add the lemon rind, a bit of the sugar. Finish adding the rest of the sugar. So we're going to add 1/2 of the milk and blend it, and then add the dry ingredients, and then do the same. Now we add the 1/2 of the dry flour mixture, and we beat again. Follow it with the remainder of the milk. And lastly, what's left of the flour mixture. And you can use your hand to just beat in the last few folds. Pour the batter into the pan, and we just spread it into the cake pan. Try to level it out. And we are now ready to put it into the oven. So once the cake comes out of the oven, we want to make sure it's cool, and then we invert it onto a serving tray. And a nice little touch is to add some icing sugar on top. We're going to add a little bit of cinnamon to the sugar to give it an extra kick, and just sift it on top. There you go. This cake is perfect for tea time.